I want to show you something. What you're looking at here is a cancer drug killing almost all brain cancer cells. And it's not just doing this in cells. This is it doing it in mice. And it's not just in brain cancer. This is it doing the same thing in lung cancer and breast cancer. In fact, this drug kills over 70 types of cancer cells, basically all solid tumors. Now, I work in the cancer research field, and trust me, we are the first ones to be skeptical when somebody says that they have found a cure to all cancers. And this is because of how diverse and complex cancers can be. But this drug, named after a little girl, isn't just working in mice and cells. Cancer patients are already taking it.
Well, it's being touted as a cancer-killing pill, and it has scientists excited that they may have found the holy grail when it comes to cancer research.
So today, we're gonna look at what they discovered and how it works. We're also gonna take a look at their results so far and what they mean for the future of cancer medicine. Oh, we're also gonna look at this touching story of the little girl behind the name of this drug. Cancer is a disease characterized by uncontrollable growth of cells. And this growth is usually caused by DNA damage. And this leads to the formation of tumors in the body. Now, some tumors can be benign and harmless, but malignant tumors can invade nearby tissues and spread to other parts of the body. And cancers can vary widely. This can be due to their origin in the body, their specific gene mutations, or even the body's individual response to them. They can arise from a multitude of cells from different tissues, including those in the skin, prostate, breast, lung, and more. Even within a single category, such as breast cancer, you're gonna find many subtypes, each with distinct properties that make them different from others. Now, this diversity in cancers means that a one-type-fits-all treatment just doesn't make sense. Targeting one specific type of mutation will only work for that type of cancer. The way cancer drug discovery usually works is by learning about a particular cancer, studying the factors, the proteins, and the mutations that are involved in that cancer, and then designing a specific drug that targets that particular mutation or protein or factor. And if this works, that drug will be specific for that particular cancer. So how does a particular drug target over 70 types of cancer? Even though cancers are different, they have a lot of things in common. And these all center around what makes them cancers in the first place: the uncontrollable cell growth. It turns out that there are proteins and genes that many of these cancers use to grow quickly. And that's how chemotherapy drugs work, by the way. They work by targeting factors involved in the rapid growth of cells. But most of these factors are also present in normal cells. That's why chemotherapy drugs can have really strong side effects. What we're looking for is a drug that can target this quick growth, but only in cancer cells. We want to leave the normal cells alone. A good example of proteins that are common in cancer cells is PCNA. And this is short for proliferating cell nuclear antigen. This protein plays a pivotal role in the growth and multiplication of cancer cells. It is found in most cancers and helps in DNA replication and repair. But PCNA is involved in all cells, not just cancer cells. But a while ago, researchers found that the version of PCNA in cancer cells is special. They called it CAPCNA. It is a different version compared to the normal one. What that meant was they could target cells with this special version of PCNA, killing cancer cells and leaving the normal cells alone. But it sounds easier said than done. A lot of researchers tried this, but none of them were successful. PCNA was deemed undruggable for a long time. But this group at the City of Hope Cancer Center in California were able to successfully target it. They did this by targeting the cancer-specific region of this protein. So they use these small molecules to find candidates that can bind to this region of the protein. The goal is to find a small molecule that can bind tightly to this protein and prevent it from functioning normally. And this is the best part because this is what we do in the lab. You start with the 3D structure of the molecule and you look for small molecules that are going to fit in that region. And you can start with thousands and sometimes even millions of small molecules and see which ones are going to fit the best. You can even test your small molecules to see if they're going to be soluble in water, if they're going to enter the cell, if they're going to be safe to consume, things like that. You can measure up to like 100 parameters. You can do all of that on a computer. We even now have artificial intelligence models that can do this faster and cheaper. We recently did a video about this, so check it out after this one. So when they found drug candidates that worked well and bound to our protein, they modified them further and tried different combinations to find even better molecules. They eventually narrowed it down to this particular molecule. Now that they had a drug candidate that inhibited the protein, they moved on to see if it's gonna work on cancer cells, and it killed pretty much most of them. This figure right here shows you that the drug induces apoptosis, which is basically self-destruction. It only does this in cancer cells, not in normal cells. You can see that we start with a lot of cancer cells here, and then they disappear. These are neuroblastoma cells, but they tried it on other cancer cells as well. Leukemia, melanoma, lung cancer, breast cancer, renal cancer, prostate cancer, and more. It has the same effect in over 70 types of cancer cells. It's good that this works in cancer cells, but how does it work in animals? Well, they tried that too. They looked at mice models of these tumor cells. This graph right here shows you breast cancer, lung cancer, and brain cancer. And you can see the tumor volume going down over time. The drug seems to work by binding to PCNA and inhibiting its interaction with other proteins.
The small molecule targets the ability of PCNA to interact with its partners. So in effect, you're shutting down a number of critical pathways of which PCNA would be a part of.
That's Dr. Linda Malkas, the lead researcher on this study. So this drug is really promising. And because of that, they've moved into clinical trials and they seem to be going pretty well. So you'll notice that this drug is called AOH1996. And this is a very special name. It's named after Anna Olivia Healy. And she was born in 1996. She was a 9-year-old who unfortunately died in 2006 from neuroblastoma. This girl, despite her age and having cancer, lived to impact and inspire a lot of people, including the lead researcher of this study, Dr. Linda Malkas. Her parents have raised over $500,000 for neuroblastoma research. Dr. Malkas was inspired to focusing on finding a cure for neuroblastoma research because of Anna's story. She's been doing that for over 20 years, and she's finally found something very promising. Cancer is devastating, and it has pretty much affected everybody I know one way or another. But I can't even imagine what that little girl went through and what the family went through as well. But I'm so glad that they used her story to impact and inspire other people. They've not only helped other families dealing with similar tragedies, but they've also contributed directly to finding a cure. I think that's amazing. So this promising study is undergoing clinical trials right now. When they did it in mice, they didn't really find any side effects. So we're hoping that it's gonna be the same thing in humans. I'll be following this story, and I'm gonna update you if anything new happens. We'll also be talking about other initiatives working on cancer cures as well. So if you wanna keep up with all that and more, stay tuned, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.